This is a 2.25 by 3.25 Graflex film holder. It's for a Graflex miniature speed graphic. That's what I've got here. I purchased this one on eBay for about $9. You can see that it has dark slides, one on each side. And it's got some little hinges here to fold back, and then can insert the film like so. There's some rails on either side that hold the film in place. There's one in the back as well. As I said, there's one on each side. What came with this, just by sheer chance, was this piece of 2.25 by 3.25 film, which is kind of nice because I didn't have any. So, you know the dimensions, of course, but it's nice to see what it actually looks like and have something to compare it to. So the film holder fits in the back of the camera like this. This is a spring back for the miniature speed graphic. They're not very desirable because the problem is there's a roll film holder that uses modern film that won't fit underneath this ground glass here. So basically the ground glass is secured to the bottom of the base of the back of the camera here, and held in place by these springs. So to insert this, you just kind of pull back on the ground glass and just insert this film holder, which is designed to fit in here. It kind of snaps into place. The problem with that is you can't get those roll film holders, or if you can, they're pretty expensive, and that wasn't really an option for me. I didn't want to spend a whole lot of money on this project. So kind of was looking around for something to do with this, and discovered that the Fuji Instax film is about the same size as this 2.25 by 3.25 film. So did some reading and research into it, and I've seen maybe one other person that has actually done this with 2.25 by 3.25. You can see that this film actually goes like this. Will fit inside quite nicely into the film holder here. Still closes without too much issue. So rather than using or trying to obtain obsolete film, possible at least to expose a piece of the Fuji Instax film. The problem that I pretty quickly found, and there's a lot of people that are playing around with Fuji Instax and trying to do self-developing. There's a packet of developer here on this film, and as it passes through the camera, the Fuji Instax camera, much like a Polaroid, it basically rolls between two rollers and squeezes that developer out evenly onto the film to develop the image. So the problem is it's very hard to do evenly if you try to do it by hand. Some people have tried rolling something across or various other methods. None of them seem to work too well. So the conclusion that most people come to is that if you just purchase a Fuji Instax camera, you can load the exposed film back into the film container that it came from and basically take a blank with your Instax camera and just roll the developed film out through those rollers, or the undeveloped film, excuse me, the exposed film, just roll it out through the rollers in your Instax camera, and it'll start the self-development process. So kind of wanted to show a little bit what that looks like here. This is the container that the Fuji Instax film comes in. And you can see this one is empty, but essentially the film is in here like this. It's just beneath these little rails on each side. On the end there's a little flimsy plastic strip here that keeps the film canister light tight, keeps from having any light leaks or anything like that. And then on the, when you look at a new container of Instax, you'll see that it has this cover on top. So you put it in the camera, the camera recognizes that it's a new pack, and then it instantly spits out this this cover, and then you'll have the next piece of film just sitting right there ready to be exposed. So what you can do is open up a container in a changing bag, a film changing bag, or dark room, or whatever you have, dark room, literal dark room. And you can pull this cover out, and then pull a sheet of the film out, and I guess in this case you'd pull two out, and all in the dark, so it's a little bit tricky, but not too bad actually. Easier in my opinion than trying to roll a roll of 120 film onto a developing spool. Then you just insert it into the film holder here and close it like so. You'll have to set your camera up and get ready to take a picture of whatever you want to take a picture of. And in my case, I used a Nikon digital SLR to just set the ISO. So the ISO rating of the Fuji Instax film is 800 ISO. So I was just using my digital SLR as a functionally as a light meter, just to figure out what my exposure needed to be. Set that up on the camera here, and then focus with the ground glass, and then insert the film holder here, remove the dark slide, and click expose the film. Reinsert the dark slide, very important step. And then you just pull out your film holder. And then after that, you're going to have to go back into your changing bag or dark room or whatever you've got. You're going to have to remove the film in the dark, of course. Try not to scratch it too bad. You'll have to put it back into the Fuji Instax container, which is a little tricky. I have found that this film flap, if there's a piece of film in there, that you can push that piece of film out to kind of open this little door, so to speak. You can do it by hand if you can see it, but that's the tricky part, is you can't see it. So it's not too bad, but anyway, you insert the piece of film back in there. You can, I guess what I discovered with my camera is you can just take what's in here and then pop it into the camera. I actually did it. Had my camera in the dark room, the Instax camera in the changing bag, I should say. And just pop this in here, and there's some springs that press on these and force the film to the top here. And so when my camera, you insert the new film canister, film packet here, it automatically spits the first thing out, which is this thing. But it doesn't know that, so it just spits that top layer of film out, and that's all I really needed. So. Yeah, that's what I did, and ended up with an exposed image. And actually, here's one that I took with the Graflex. So works. A little complicated, a little messy, but if you think about it, it's easier than obtaining and developing 2.25 by 3.25 film. So pretty cool. Brings a camera built in 1939. Back to life.